We have time for a couple of questions. Yeah, please go ahead, sir.
Hi, I would just like to extend Krishna.
Can you please introduce yourself, sir?
Yeah, I am Devang Badiani from SGFC Limited, and I would like to extend Krishnakant's challenge that, you know, 95% of the applications are uninstalled from the mobile. So how do you, and my question is to the entire panel, what are the strategies that you would have envisioned apart from the typical ones like adding value to the customer and all that? What are the specific strategies that you would envision or implement to ensure that your app is used and is adding value to the customer?
Sure.
Okay.
As far as I'm speaking from an insurance perspective, as far as what we can do for the customer, there are some regulatory limits on what we can offer or what are the kind of price points or discounts that one can offer. So purely from that perspective, perhaps there is limited space there. But if you look at some of the add-ons or some of the benefits that you can offer in the non-monetary space. So for example, if you know that the person's going to be avidly trading, and some of these statistics can be harvested on the mobile by the app because you have your asset on the guy's mobile, and mobile devices today are actually publishing out a bunch of information which, if you harvest correctly, you can push tips to him. You can push to him that this is probably a right time for you to switch from a certain fund to another fund of yours. All funds managed by me, but probably the customer is not really an active investor, so I can probably assist him in doing that. There are certain opportunities presented to us where we can do an upsell. And he is not even aware that there is a certain add-on product that he can buy, but we can probably push some of those to him. Additionally, I think purely from the non-insurance space, there are some offers. There are a lot of channels that are willing to come to us, willing to offer products for customers. We can enable the transaction between that particular channel and the customer. So these are some of the things that we feel we can do to make sure that the app stays on top of his mind and he keeps coming back to the app every once a day or every once in a week to check on what's new. And that's the way we believe that we should be able to engage the customer.
You want to add something, Shil, sir?
See, one of the most important thing is, like I said previously also, what you need to do is first you need to do the analysis. You need to understand what are the reasons why the apps are getting deactivated, right? Why there is a 50% of deactivation of app after it is being uploaded. You need to understand whether genuinely they are customers, because there are few apps which have been downloaded even by your competition one. Keep aside, that percentage is not going to be very huge. You're going to have few customers, most of them are carrying multiple phones. So what happens typically is people don't carry two Android phones. They have a combination of Windows Android or iOS Android or iOS Windows. And they typically would like to, as a consumer, would like to download your app and understand the interface in which phone it is quite good. Once you understand the different flavors of consumers and the reason for it, you have to get back to the customer. You can't just, you have enough of information coming in the app stores on why they are not quite happy about. You need to connect back to the customer. Here is where a CIO has to play a role of a chief digital officer. So it's beyond technology, right? You need to play a role of understanding why he's going out and how you can build those marketing strategies in place to win him back. So do you have a team which connects back to the customer to understand the specific reason why he's going out? Do you have an offers to bring him back? Do you understand that he has got two phones and he has downloaded one and is deactivated? So let go that customer. Probably he's also giving you a message that he's quite happy with the interface being on the iOS. He's not quite happy with the interface being on Windows, which is an area of improvement for you. So you need to keep connecting to the customer, collect back the information, and build your marketing strategy. So this cannot be solved by the technology strategy. This has nothing to do with the technology. It is more to do with understanding the consumer behavior, build your marketing strategy, build your feature list from the product's perspective, and render it back to the customer.
See, adding to that, it depends. Like now, if it's a business lead, app is given, you should get the incentives. See, everything works with some schemes. Nothing works free. Okay, so it's purely incentive. If it's with your executive, then it should be connected to the RBMI, some incentive to him. If it's customer, then the rebate. It's purely commercial, to be honest. Nothing to do with technology. As much schemes, they do it. Generally, if it's a Maruti, then they come out with whatever it is. If it's again Mahindra, purely product schemes, apps, business leads, goes with the schemes. If you do the first one, if you do the top 10, they keep on announcing it. That's the way apps are seen. And you can see also the top out of all coming out with so many people use, touched, the top, you can see like what the incentive they have announced. That's the way to see.
Right. Yes, sir.
I'm Shankar Narayan from HDFC. Just have a question to, I think, Mr. Shah regarding eKYC. I think I just want to know some, whether you have already implemented or you have any plans to implement, how you are planning to do eKYC to the customer using mobile app?
Yeah, as long as the verifier ID part is concerned, we have already started validating the Aadhaar number and the PAN number on our devices. So when we get that data, as part of the initial check, we already do it, whether it's a data entry error or not. The second step is which we are going into the eKYC where our pilots are just going on. And we see in our microfinance business that really working out because the touch base with the customer is high. So where the documentation is really low, so I think that would be winning. But this has to be done with your finger-based thing. The OTP part will not work because typically in prepaid mobile, the numbers are always keep on changing. So that's the way it will really work.
So how will you do fingerprint based? So are you
expecting
the customer to have the biometric device or however?
No. See, what we give is for our internal customer, internal sales executive, we already given them mobile with an external hand devices, which are certified by the eKYC Aadhaar.
Yeah.
So that is given. Basis that he puts a fingerprint and
Goes to the customer and gets
it. Goes to the customer because for us, customer is always the touch point which is there.
Okay.
Because we are in the lending business. So at any point of time, the KYC is taken from the customer, either at the dealer location or at the individual location.
Okay. Excuse me. Thanks.
So, okay, we'll take a final question.
Hello. Yeah, hi, this is Pratap here from IndusInd Bank. Okay, see, one of the things which we have noticed across is that certainly what is the incentive there for a customer to go back and use your app? Okay, so today if you see a lot of transactions are being charged. So when we talking about the banking sector, if a customer is going and doing an NEFT or let's say any kind of a transfer through mobile app, there are differential charges which are being charged to the customer. So what is it that will motivate a customer to go back and use a mobile app? So maybe some discount offer which he has, like if you talk about the online marketing platform today on a Flipkart or anything, there are stuffs which are only available on app. So it's like only app offer. So anything of that sort which has been worked out?
See, if you see some are bold steps taken by some e-com players where they have moved from website to app, so you're forced to. There are some where you are incentive. If you see Uber and all, you'll always see which taxi is free and go and buy that. So basically, as rightly mentioned, you have to have a marketing strategy in place on how you want to hook the customers. Somewhere you give incentive, he uses more app. Look at the analytics piece, which is a very critical piece to tie back to the customer that this customer is always doing mobile app, is not coming to the branch. I will incentivize him by not charging him an annual fee if he doesn't go down with the maintenance. So these are the strategies on the analytics piece which we'll have to really hone in to give him that piece of freebies, as we really call him. Or you tie up with other players, like if you do X number of transactions, you'll get a Flipkart voucher of 250 rupees free or this. That's the way you are going to incentivize the customer. So it's again a commercial transaction with a mix of analytics and marketing strategy which will really work to hook the customers. And servicing is a very easy aspect. So maybe some customers are always used to that, I want to do transaction at 10 o'clock in the night. Then it's ease on a tab of a button. So again, the app should be easy to use on a single click. That's what is the key to it.
But if the question is that just like the e-com players who are actually trying to divert the customers to the app through the offer of app-only offers, does that hold true in our businesses? I think the nature of the challenge is different. In the case of the e-com players, they actually found that their infra was unable to keep up with the pace of which customers were coming to the websites, and therefore they were trying to divert as much of that activity from an online to the app. In our case, I think the nature of the challenge is that we anyways have a bunch of activities happening on the website, and the same bunch we are providing an alternate channel. So it's not as if the challenge is to try to divert a certain bunch of customers away from one medium to the other. The challenge actually is to try and make sure that even on the app, he does not walk away from the app. The engagement continues after he has gotten onto the app.
See, one of the strategic way that we have done in our organization is we have built a loyalty program. So how do we build a loyalty program, especially in BFSI sector, right? If he does a trading transactions, we hardly earn any brokerage. It's in paises, 10 paises, 2 paises, and stuff like that. You can't give a discount on the broking which he has done, or you can't give a discount on the NFT transaction that he does. So how do we assign a loyalty program matrices for each of the transaction and engagement he does? How do you do a collection of this loyalty program and link it back in terms of a rewards that can be given to him? So what we have done from our side is for every transaction that he does, we give him a loyalty points. For every mobile app he downloads and he uses it, we give him some set of loyalty points, which means we have defined certain transaction behavior, behavior in terms of his engagement with us. We have assigned the rules in terms of points, and we have linked it back to other e-commerce website like Flipkart, where he can use those points and redeem it. This is the best way to incentivize the customers more in terms of engagement, where it's a win-win situation where he gets a redemption in terms of points, he gets what he wants. At the same time, we increase our traffic, and also it also helps us in improving the engagement with the customer.
Great. So you have a question, sir. So final question from the gentleman in the check shirt.
Yeah, hi. I'm Vikas, and my question is to Mr. Varadarajan, sir. How do you think that, you know, whether the mobile applications are going to replace ATM machines acquiring business? I'm going to say whether, how are you, that's my first question. And second is, what is your strategy for increasing number of transactions in terms of banking perspective, wherein cash in, cash out happens?
To be frank with you, as long as cash is going to be in the industry, it is difficult to remove ATM. If you see, I come with the ATM background, so I've seen the transformation happening on ATM. If you see, ATM was just used for cash withdrawal and cash deposit. But now if you see, there are multiple transactions which have occurred. So ATM has already transformed itself. Now, will it remain a box where I do cash? It could be one of the transactions. But today, as bankers and as the maturity level of industries are growing, there are multiple. You can book your tickets, you can do NEFT transactions, you can order a checkbook. There are multiple ways of using ATM. ATM per se will not go. It's a use of transaction. But as long as cash is there in the system, it will be there. So I see the next transformation, as I already mentioned, is the mobile wallet. As the adaptability increases, cash will go less and less. But will ATM go? No. It will be here to say, for small transaction, as long as you are not able to do without cash, ATMs are here to stay.
Great. Thank you so much, sir.